In this video, we're gonna talk about the recruitment and the selection process in connection to the course project. Recruitment and selections are important processes that help companies find the right people for the right job. So recruitment is based on finding people who are interested in working for a company and who have the skills and experience needed for a particular job. Selection is about choosing the best person for the job from among those who have applied. So, for example, if a company needs someone to work in their marketing department, they will advertise the job and ask people to apply. They will then look at all the applications they receive and choose the persons who think is the best suited for the job. The purpose of recruitment and selection is to make sure that companies find the right people for their job. This helps companies be more successful because they have people who are skilled and experienced in their jobs. Recruitment. Recruitment is when a company looks for people who are interested in working for them and who have the skills they need to do a job. So they might put up job postings online or in newspapers. Or they might ask people they know if they're interested in working for them. So once people apply for a job, the company will look at their resumes and decide if they want to interview them. So if they like what they hear during the interview, they might offer the person a job. In recruitment, we have these four steps. So let's dive in. Number one, identify the job vacancy. Second, conduct job analysis. Third, prepare document preparation. And the last one is advertise the vacancy. Identify a job vacancy is the first step in the recruitment process. Businesses must identify that the job vacancy is available within their organization and then advertise the vacancy. Job analysis is a process that helps identify and determine in detail the particular job duties and requirements and the relative importance of these duties for a given job. It can be used to identify whether a vacancy needs to be filled or whether the tasks and duties can be redistributed to other staff. And the third is the documentation preparation in recruitment process involves preparing two key documents, a person's specification to define the type of person the business wishes to recruit, and a job description which outlines the duties and responsibilities of the job. And the last step, which is the fourth step, is the advertising a job vacancy. Can be done either internally or externally. Internal advertising means that the job is advertised within the company, while external advertising means that it is advertised outside of the company. Recruitment splits in two categories, internal and external. So for internal recruitment is when a company files vacancies within its existing workforce instead of looking for candidates outside of the company. So this can be done by promoting employees from within the same organization to a higher position. One of the most notable advantage of these recruitment processes is the lower cost. And next is the external recruitment, is when a company looks for candidates outside of the company to fill vacancies instead of promoting employees from within the same organization. Common ways of attracting candidates include the employer's website, commercial job board, recruitment agencies, and professional networking sites such as LinkedIn. In selection process, these three things has to be observed. Number one, shortlist applications. 2, conduct interview and assessment. 3, select a successful applicant and offer them role. The selection process is the process of selecting and shortlisting the right candidates with the necessary qualifications and skill set to fill the vacancies in an organization. The selection process varies from industry to industry, company to company, and even amongst departments of the same company. So, shortlisting is the process of identifying candidates from the applicant pool that best meet the requirements and criteria of a job posting, and who will be moved forward in the recruiting process. In other words, creating a short list or narrow down selection of qualified candidates whom an organization wants to contact. Second, after shortlisting candidates, the next step is a recruitment process, is conducting interviews and assessments. An interview is a conversation between an employer and a job candidate where the employer evaluates whether the candidate is suitable for the job. So assessments after an interview can filter candidates based on a set of criteria that meets your organization's needs. Number three is the last one is the after conducting interviews and assessments, the next step is a recruitment process, is selecting successful applicant and offering them a role. This means that the employer will choose the best candidate for the job based on their qualifications, expenses, experience, and other factors. Hi there, I'm excited to introduce to you our company, XYZ Incorporated. We are a software development company that specializes in creating mobile apps for businesses. Our team is made up of talented developers who are passionate about creating innovative solutions for our clients. We're always looking for new talent to join our team, and we think you'd be a great fit if you're interested in learning more about our company and what we do. Please don't hesitate to reach out. Thank you.
We are in the last presentation of this video. So let's get started. Question number one. Tell me about yourself.
I'm a software developer with 5 years of experience working on web applications. I specialize in front-end development and have experience with HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and Java. In my current role, I've led several successful projects that have resulted in increased revenue for my company. I'm excited about this position because it would allow me to continue working with Java while also expanding my skills in back-end development.
That's impressive. So, second question, what was your specific role and responsibilities for the most recent project you work on?
In my most recent project, I was responsible for developing a new feature for our company's website. My role involved working with a team of developers to design and implement the feature. I was responsible for writing code, testing it, and ensuring that it met our quality standards. One of the biggest challenges we faced was integrating the new feature with our existing systems, but we were able to overcome this by working closely with our IT team.
What is the project you are most proud of, and how did you contribute to it?
The project I am most proud of is a mobile app that I developed for a local charity organization. The app was designed to help people donate money to the organization easily and securely. My role involved working with a team of developers to design and implement the app. I was responsible for writing code, testing it, and ensuring that it met our quality standards. One of the biggest challenges we faced was integrating the app with our existing systems, but we were able to overcome this by working closely with our IT team.
Do you prefer to work alone or on a team?
I'm comfortable working both alone and as part of a team. I think it's important to be able to work independently when necessary, but also to be able to collaborate with others when it's beneficial.
Which programming languages do you know well?
I'm familiar with several programming languages, including C++, Java, and Python. I've used C++ for several years now and have worked on several projects using it. I've also used Java for web development projects and Python for data analysis and machine learning projects.
Okay. What is your favorite programming language and why? Please explain.
My favorite programming language is Python because it's easy to learn and has a lot of libraries that can be used for data analysis and machine learning.
Sounds good. Next, my last question. Describe a time you successfully led a project.
I was responsible for leading a team of developers on a software development project for a client. My role involved managing the project timeline, communicating with stakeholders, and ensuring that all deliverables were completed on time. One challenge we faced was a tight deadline for delivery of the final product. To overcome this challenge, I worked closely with my team to prioritize tasks and ensure that everyone was working efficiently. As a result of our efforts, we were able to deliver the final product ahead of schedule.